Okay, folks, welcome back. I'm going to be trying different lenses on my A7C. I got all the full frame ones out. So this is the Z30. This is a 35 millimeter f1.8. And if I go on to a zoom real quick, it's pretty good. I've adjusted no colors or anything, the gamma, saturation, or on this setup here in the office studio. Everything is perfect right out of the camera. So Z30 looks great. If I go to the puppy cam, well, there's Wanda. Already going to bed. Start of the show. Buddy's walking around here somewhere. TV. It looks great. Everything right out of the camera. That's a ZFC. This is the ZFC also. So I have two different ZFCs. If I go to the A6100, here's a Sony lens that I am using for the A6100, just to compare. And let's see. Yeah. Okay. Very good. See, I'm always trying to fix stuff. Yeah, look at that. And it's already in all the way. Yep, that'll be done. So this is the 6100, and here's the zoom. And then I can move this down also. The way you can center things out is you go clear out all the way to zero. You center it this way. So that's about it. Of course, I see the curvature right there. Yeah, it's not perfect. But anyway, to hide all that, you just go to the zoom right here, and you just block it out. This is where you really test to see if you're in okay, messed up. Sorry. Okay. So, camera is probably trying to stay center as possible. I got on center of the cutting board, but the center for the camera is right about here, which is annoying. And I'm tired of moving the boom arm. So, anyhow, I do it like that. And you just bring it a little bit closer. That way you don't see the edges. And that's good enough, right there. And then, of course, you can make it sharp if you want to. So just do a little bit like... See, I got autofocus... There we go. I got autofocusing on, but that helps. And Sony's is a little bit darker. They're not as bright. But this is an f2.8 lens. And, of course, here's the Sony A7C. The 24 millimeters, the first one I'm going to show you off. So, colors look great on this monitor. I just viewed something on YouTube that I put up earlier, and I look red for some reason. And when I'm looking at all the settings straight, something happened on the YouTube rendering. So this is a close-up of me of 24 millimeters. It's kind of like the 16 millimeter on the APS-C. So with the 1.5 crop, this is what you see. You can get a little bit closer, like a lot of people do, you know, to get a close up. Let me go back to wider field, so then you get a little bit closer. Some people like it still wide field of view, and you can always mess with the you know, how close you are and stuff. But anyhow, this is just one lens. So let's go to the next one. So anyhow, now I got the 40 millimeter f2.8 on here. I'm a little bit bigger. If I go to the zoom, which is this one right here, okay, I'm out of the picture. Now I can fix that by going like this, but I'm too big. So you can always adjust it a little bit, and then you can just move it around. Right, I'm going to adjust it a little bit more. Okay. So anyhow, you can also adjust it like this. You know, just move to center you, okay? So what I'm using is, I'm not using a tripod. I got the A7C plugged into the USB-C port with the Elgato Camlink 4K. And I'm using a little clip to center the lens, and that's, you know, to give me the height. That's what I'm using. Just give me a little height. I put it underneath the lens, and it keeps it stable, but right underneath the lens. So it gives the camera a little breathing room also. It works for me, okay? So I thought that might be interesting for a setup. Let's see if I can get another point of view. Yeah, I can do that. So I'll move my 40 millimeter, and this is the 24 millimeter that I just used. Take out the lens cap. Look how tiny that is. Isn't that something? But you see, 40 millimeters is excellent. I use the 35 millimeter on the Z30. 40 millimeter doesn't beat, you know. It's just a little bit more, but I think it's excellent for vlogging. For the APC or APS-C, it gives you like a 60 millimeter. So let me turn it this way, right here. Okay, focus it. I'm going to focus that part on the camera itself. Yeah, on that green thing. There we go. So, this is what you're looking at right here. And if I can get the mouse to work. Yeah, right there. There's the camera, folks. Okay, now, reason why it was shaking a little bit, my desktop screen just changed. I noticed that it affects Ecamm for some reason. But anyhow, that's what the camera looks like. And as you can see, I got the different lenses right here. So let's go to another lens. I'll go back from the 40 to see what the next one is. Okay, just by putting another lens, so I went from 40 millimeters to 50 millimeters, and it's the G lens, the compact lens. So it's about the same size as the 40 millimeter. Okay, it has that strange hood on here. But anyway, it's clear. And what I like about the Sony is you can put a product in front. You can see how fast the focusing is. And I take it down. Look at that. You can't beat the auto-focusing. So what I also like about it is you don't get that focus breathing too, unless you do this. See? Try not to do that. So this is the 50mm 2.5 compact lens. That looked pretty good, right? So if I go into the zoom, I look like this. It's pretty good. I love the 50mm, okay? But I have to back up a little bit so I can fit in the picture. And on the Ecamm Live, I can zoom it, make it bigger, slower, and then when you zoom it, I can move the little rectangle picture that's highlighted that you see on the screen right now. So I look pretty good. So this is the 50mm. Now I'm going to try something else. So what I have here, as you can see with the TV camera, the other ZFC, I have the A7C with the 50mm f1.8. Now, believe it or not, it's still the same focal length of the 2.5, but all lenses aren't created evil, or equal, I should say. So if I go to the Sony A7C, believe it or not, I look a little bit lighter. Okay, so they have a different stuff on top of the lens. So I look a little bit more white, or a little bit lighter, as it looks like. And if I get a closer look, you see, I haven't changed any of the settings. I just moved the lens a little bit so I can center my face. And I can move this down just a hair. Okay. So this may be more than 50 millimeters, you know, that you're looking at. So they may, the manufacturers may say 50 millimeters, but they're approximating. And it may not be exact. So this f1.8 is like maybe a 52, 51. So I'm bigger in the picture, and I haven't done any of the settings on the Ecamm Live. And if I were, I would go something like this. So now it looks like the same as before. But you can see how much it cropped in. So this is a 50mm f1.8. Can you tell the difference between the 2.5 and 1.8? I kind of like the 2.5. I think it's better color. So anyhow, let's go to the next set of lens. So you can't tell, but I'm a little bit farther away. I'll move the mic a little bit closer. But as you can see, there's the mic. The low power, or low profile boom arm, which I love. This is, and let me get it right here, the Sony 85mm f1.8, one of my favorite focal lengths. I'm starting to like the 105. I think I would rather have 135mm, but this one right here, 85mm, it's excellent. I like the 50mm and I like the 85mm on with the lenses on different cameras. I always have those two type of lenses on each camera that I have. So like on the APS-C, the 56mm Sigma f1.4 is a must have. All right, so it gives me an 84mm, almost 85. And like the 30mm Sigma is like a 45, close to a 50. And then of course I got the 16, which is on the Sigma, which is a 24. But on the Sony, right here is the 85mm, and this is the zoom. So I'm a little bit further away from the light, but it's an excellent lens. You see, you get detail, and if I really zoom it, just show you how sharp the picture is. So anyhow, one more lens to go, and then I'm done. So you probably can't tell, but I got one of the bigger lenses on here. And this is another prime, and this is going to shock you. So prepare yourself. I hope you're sitting down watching this. I'm tiny. This is 20 millimeter f1.8. So I started with the 24 millimeter, which I thought was kind of small. I like the 50 millimeter 2.5 the best, you know, for vlogging. Well, I had the 40 millimeter. I'm sorry, the 40 millimeter I like, but that's the 2.5 also. So this is a 20 millimeter, and it's on zoom. I can't get it any bigger. So if I had like maybe the CVE 10, I can use the tight and wide switch, and it might get me a little bit closer. But I look farther away. I tried all the prime lenses that I have, and basically that's all I have, is the prime lenses for this camera, except for the kit lens, which is 28-60, which I'll show you right now, and that way you can choose which one you like the best. So last but not least, this is the kit lens. As you can see, I got it extended. You got to extend it to get it to at least 28 millimeters. And this is how it looks. How do I look? 28-60. Peter Gregg sent me this lens by accident when he was testing out the A7C. And I put it on my A6100. And I loved it. A lot of people don't like the kit lens, because it's variable apertures, but for everyday usage, this is a 28 millimeters. A lot of people like the 28 millimeter area, especially for taking pictures. So this is 28, and this is at, let's do the zoom. This is all the way to the zoom, and I should have done this before. Look at that center. That looks pretty good. So if you decide to just do a studio, just for vlogging purposes or live streaming or stuff like that, 28 millimeter is fantastic. So this is 28 millimeters. This right here is 35 millimeters. So the 20 is real small, 24. You saw the 28, this is now the 35 millimeter. And if I zoom it, it looks pretty good, doesn't it? Now, it may be not as clear as some of the primes and stuff, but still, at 4K, what are you complaining about? It's an excellent lens. And it's great for, for traveling. This lens will take care of it. I would take the Trio. You have a different point of view. I might just take all of them. I don't know. But anyway, let's go to... So on the other range, this is the 50... No, this is the 40 millimeter. You saw the 40 millimeter before. And if I go to the zoom... I can get a little bit smaller, but still. It's pretty good. How do I look? It looks pretty good, doesn't it? So it's a 40 millimeter. Now we're going to go to, let's say, the 50 millimeter. Now, the one thing about this lens, it's very tight, where you go 28, 35, 40, all right? That's expected. But then there's a big jump to 50, and then another big jump to 60. I don't know why, but that's the way they have the lens. So I guess if you put it on a camera with the whitened tie, which I haven't done, but I will put it on a ZV-E10, I'll see if they'll do the different ranges. I have used it using the eCam, and I can do that with the program. So, for an example, this is the zoom, right? This is just fitting it in the window, okay? So this is the actual size that you see. And then, of course, if I make myself bigger and then just move the window, there you have it. That's 40 millimeters. Let's go to the 50. Okay, here's the 50 millimeter. Now, it's a little bit darker because my screen in front of me, which also adds a little light, is showing something about space, you know, the Earth and the Moon, and it's real dark right now. So I may seem a little bit dark than the previous ecliptic or lens that you just saw me, but this is the 50 millimeter. I look pretty clear. And then if I go into the zoom part, what do you think? I can also move it like this. Now center it a little bit more. What do you think? It looks pretty good, right? 50 millimeter. One last one. I promise. So, and let me try to center it a little bit. This is a 60 millimeter. How do I look? It's a little bit darker because of variable aperture. I think it's 6.3 now. So, but on a bright sunny day, still good. 60 millimeters, not bad. And then if I go into the zoom, there you have it. Okay. So I got a little light just from the lamp, but what do you think? Kit lens is fine to start off with, but then you pick your prime lens for either video or for your shooting or whatever. But these lens are very cheap. Well, they're cheaper than most. I've been spending over thousands of bucks, you know, for different types of lenses. These are like, oh gosh, I was picking them up for like $150, $200, $600 for the Trio. Another cheaper for the 50. The 85 was about 600 that I got, and then of course the 20 millimeter was 900. So that's the most expensive lens. And so this is the kit lens. So which lens do I like using for this video vlog? Can you guess? I'll give you 10 seconds. All right, can you guess? It's pretty good. Let's see, let's go to maybe this should help. Can you see the lens? Let's zoom it. Well, that doesn't help, does it? Well, let's see. I got the 24, which I started off with this video. I got the 50 2.5. I got the other 50, f1.8. I got the 85 millimeter, f1.8. And then the last lens, before I put on this zoom lens, is the 20. And then, of course, the kit lens is back there. So which lens did I choose? Come on, this is a test, people. What is it? Write it down in the comments below. Well, you don't have to. I'll tell you. So on this one, it's the 40 millimeter 2.5, one I picked up the other day. I also picked up the 20 millimeter. So 24 was too small, 20 is real small. Don't have a 35 millimeter because I usually use 35 millimeters for you know, for the studio. I got like the 28 millimeter on Wanda. I got the 40 millimeter on that camera back there that I've been showing off. So 35 is right in the middle. I would say 28 to 40 is fine for your vlogging. A lot of people use 50 millimeter, but then they have to back up a little bit. But this is zoomed. I can make it bigger. But you see, that's a little bit too much. Overimposing, right? So it's nice to have a little background. It's a little blur, in a, you know, but I'm not going for that. I'm going to the presenter. That's a good size right there. And I'll keep it right there. So this is the actual size as you get out of the camera. And what is that? It's showing something. Oh, that's what it's showing. Okay. So, anyway, I guess I can do this. Bring it up a little bit closer. Does it go away? Yeah, it's still there. Yeah, I may have to go to the 50 millimeter. Oh, well. I hope you like this video. And that way I can get rid of it. You don't have to look at it. And I might move it back. Okay. Put my little clip on here underneath the lens to give it the right height. So anyhow, hope you enjoy this video. Of course, let me center myself. There we go. And as always, if you like this video, please give me a like, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and any questions, just write a comment on below. I was looking at a different zoom lens, like the 14, or I think it's the 14 to 35 or stuff like that. And then I was looking at the 70 to 200. But I haven't decided with the Sony because I wanted something small for street photography. Small lenses, not heavy, where you can get like pictures of people. And a lot of people like using the 35 millimeter, but since I don't have a 35 millimeter for Sony, I have the 40 millimeter, I like this lens. But anyhow, as always, stay safe, keep smiling. Until next time, goodbye. Let's see if I can find the mouse. Yeah, that's in the video like this. Bye, folks.